Welcome to Piping Engineering World. Today we are going to learn about types of flanges used in piping system. Before going to watch the video, please click on the bell icon to subscribe the channel to get more updates from Piping Engineering World. A flange is a method of connecting pipes, valves, pumps and other equipment to form a piping system. It also provides easy access for cleaning, inspection or modification. Flanges are usually welded or screwed. A flange joint is composed of three separate and independent although interrelated components, the flanges, the gaskets, and the bolting, which are assembled by yet another influence, the fitter. Special controls are required in the selection and application of all these elements to attain a joint, which has acceptable tightness. There are different types of pipe flanges used in the piping systems depending upon the fluid, PT rating, material of construction, connecting equipment, etc. Below are the types of flanges used in piping based on facing. Most commonly used pipe flanges are welding neck flange, long welding neck, slip-on flange, threaded flange, sacket-weld flange, lap joint flange, blind flange, stub end. Number 1, welding neck flange. Welding neck flanges are easy to recognize at a long tapered hub that goes gradually over to the wall thickness from a pipe or fitting. This flange type is used, normally, in high pressure and high, low temperatures applications that require an unrestricted flow of the fluid conveyed by the piping system. The bore of the flange matches with the bore of the pipe. These flanges are bored to match the inside diameter of the mating pipe or fitting, so there will be no restriction of product flow. This prevents turbulence at the joint and reduces erosion. They also provide excellent stress distribution through the tapered hub and are easily radiographed for flaw detection. This flange type will be welded to a pipe or fitting with a single full penetration, V-weld, butt weld. Number 2, long welding neck. Long weld neck flanges are similar to weld neck flanges, with the exception that the neck, tapered hub, is extended and acts like a boring extension. Long weld neck flanges are generally used on vessels, columns or barrels. These flange types are available also in the heavy barrel, HB, and equal barrel, E, types. Number 3, slip-on flange. Slip-on pipe flanges. As made obvious by their name, these pipe flanges slip over the pipe. They're manufactured with an inside diameter that is slightly bigger than the pipe's outside diameter. These attachments are connected to the pipe by a fillet weld at the top and bottom of the flange. This type of flange is available in large size also to connect big bore piping with storage tank nozzles. Normally, these flanges are forged construction and are provided with a hub. Sometimes, these flanges are fabricated from plates and are not provided with a hub. Number 4, threaded flange. Threaded flanges are also known as crude flange, and it is having a thread inside the flange bore which fits on the pipe with matching male thread on the pipe. Threaded flanges are used for special circumstances, with their main advantage being that they can be attached to the pipe without welding. Sometimes a seal weld is also used in conjunction with the threaded connection, but this type of joint connection is speedy and simple but not suitable for high pressure and temperature applications. Threaded flanges are mostly used in utility services such as air and water. Threaded flanges are available in sizes up to 4 inches in multiple pressure ratings, however, they are used, mostly, small size piping in low pressure and low temperature applications, like water and air utility services. Threaded flanges are also a mandatory requirement in explosive areas, such as gas stations and plants, as the execution of welded connections in such environments would be dangerous. Number 5, sacket weld flange. Sacket weld flanges are connected to pipes using a single fillet weld executed on the outer side of the flange, different from the slip-on flange type that requires two welds. According to ASME B31.1, to execute a flanged connection using a socket weld flange, the pipe shall be at first inserted in the socket of the flange until it reaches the bottom of the flange, then it should be lifted by 1.6 mm and finally welded. This gap shall be left to allow proper positioning of the pipe inside the flange socket after the solidification of the weld. Socket weld flanges are used for small size and high pressure piping that do not transfer highly corrosive fluids. This due to the fact that these flange types are subject to corrosion in the gap area between the end of the pipe and the shoulder of the socket. Their static strength of socket weld flanges is similar to slip-on flanges, but their fatigue strength is higher due to the presence of a single, instead of double, fillet weld. Number 6. Lap joint flange. Lap flanges having two components, a stub end, and a loose backing flange. Stub end is butt welded to the pipe and backing flange freely move over the pipe. The backing flange can be of different material than stub material and normally of the carbon steel to save the cost. Lap flanges used where frequent dismantling is required, and space is constrained. Furthermore, a standard lap joint flange will typically have a longer hub length in comparison to a slip-on flange, but this is often considered unnecessary for many applications. The lap joint flange is practically identical to a slip-on flange except it has a radius at the intersection of the bore and flange face. The lap joint flange is practically identical to a slip-on flange except it has a radius at the intersection of the bore and flange face. This radius is necessary to have the flange accommodate a lap joint stub end. Normally, a lap joint flange and a lap joint stub end are mated together as an assembly system. Number 7. Stub end. A stub end always will be used with a lap joint flange, as a backing flange. This flange connections are applied in low pressure and non-critical applications, and is a cheap method of flanging. In a stainless steel pipe system, for example, a carbon steel flange can be applied, because they are not come in contact with the product in the pipe. Stub ends are available in almost all pipe diameters. Dimensions and dimensional tolerances are defined in the ASME B.16.9 standard. Lightweight corrosion resistant stub ends, fittings, are defined in MSSSP 43. Number 8. Blind flange. Contrary to all the flange types seen above, blind flanges do not have a center hole, and are used to blind or seal a pipeline, a valve, pressure vessel and block the flow of the fluid. Blind flanges have to withstand remarkable mechanical stress due to the system pressure and the required bolting forces. Blind flanges allow easy access to the pipeline, as they can be easily unbolted to let the operator execute activities inside the terminal end of the pipe. This is also the reason why the blind flange type is used as manhole for pressure vessels, at times. It is maybe interesting to observe that, while this flanges type is easier to manufacture, they are sold at a premium average cost per kilogram compared to the other flange types. Materials used for flanges. Pipe flanges are manufactured in all the different materials like stainless steel, cast iron, aluminium, brass, bronze, plastic, etc. But the most used material is forged carbon steel and have machined surfaces. In addition, flanges, like fittings and pipes, for specific purposes sometimes internally equipped with layers of materials of a completely different quality as the flanges themselves, which are lined flanges. The material of a flange is basically set during the choice of the pipe. In most cases, a flange is of the same material as the pipe. All flanges discussed on this website fall under the ASME and ASTM standards, unless otherwise indicated. ASME B16.5 describes dimensions, dimensional tolerances, etc., and ASTM the different material qualities. Thanks for watching the video. Please do not forget to subscribe.